Meron lang po tayong advice dito, libre, na ito po ay actual practice ng mga physical therapist. Ito po ay physical therapist si Rachel Malasig ng Texas. Pakinggan po ninyo para sa ating mga PT kung paano ang mga dapat nyong malaman if you're in a rehab facility sa Texas. Advice to PTs who are coming to Texas?
PTs who are coming to Texas, lots of studying to do. Mm-hmm. And
did you have a hard time making the transition from a PT in the Philippines to here?
A hard time? I would not so much. Mm-hmm. Actually, work is easy. It's just like getting the license. In the process of getting it is the hard part. But once you're doing the work, it's fun. And you just need to look into where you're good at.
In life, let's say in the shoulder, before we have an exercise, we'd, you know, they'd be sitting and we'd have that over the shoulder. Mm-hmm. Increases circulation, decreases the swelling. And then that allows them to exercise more if they're not hurting.
Could be orthopedic, could be with the nursing facility, mm-hmm. could be with the pediatrics. Yeah, just finding where your calling is, I would say.
How about in Virginia? Did you work as a PT?
No, I did not. I was raising 3 little kiddos.
Okay.
I'm a stay-at-home mom. Mm-hmm. Yes. Mm-hmm.
But it's ultrasound, mm-hmm. and it's for wounds. We apply, let's say I have a wound there, we apply it on the wound like that, and it cleanses the wound, it gets the bacteria out of there, it takes the slough out, mm-hmm. because that's the only time it will start healing, if we could get all that gunk out.
Did you work as a PT in the Philippines?
In the Philippines, no, not at all, mm-hmm. yes. Because those days, for you to get more money, I was more into sales.
Oh, okay.
Yes. Just to get that big bucks. Mm-hmm. And then mm-hmm. the time when I graduated, they don't hire as much here in the States anymore. In 95?
Yeah.
Right. I think the last one day was in 93. There was like a big pool of physical therapists coming in and then they stopped.
If they want to do shoulders, this you can do for her. Even if they're at the wheelchair, mm-hmm. they can work their back.
Oh.
At a wheelchair.
Okay.
But if they can stand up, then it goes all the way up. Mm-hmm.
Did you come here on a work visa, immigrant visa, as a PT? Sponsored you?
My husband's work, but he is an engineer.
Okay.
Yes.
So he was the one who got an immigrant visa based on the work?
Yes, a working visa.
Working visa,
yes.
So that must be an H-1B?
H-1. I'm H-1B, so I cannot work until I get my, I'm a dependent.
Right.
And during that time, I was studying, you know, getting my license and all, which is not really easy because they mm-hmm. require you to get your TOEFL scores. Mm-hmm. And here in Texas, there's a certain category. Speaking part should be 26 and writing should be 24. Mm-hmm. And that's not easy. I would say it requires a lot of practice. Like, you know, I don't know, you really need to speak with.
Are they accepting IELTS for PTs? IELTS is a different language proficiency exam. You know, it's TOEFL and TSE.
I'm not very familiar with that, but okay. with the requirement of the Texas board, mm-hmm. TOEFL is what they want you to get, mm-hmm. you know, with a certain score.